In the world of women's gymnastics, athletes can compete in two sports, artistic gymnastics and rhythmic.
That's right. In artistic gymnastics, they jump on balance beams and swing on uneven bars. That's the gymnastics most of us know. But in rhythmic gymnastics, they combine dance with the use of apparatus, hoops, and ribbons.
Wow, ribbons. And well, they say if artistic gymnastics is about strength and power, then rhythmic gymnastics is about grace and beauty.
And that's what our next guest is all about, grace and beauty. At just 16 years old, she's the rhythmic gymnastics champion of the Philippines. And she joins us today fresh from competition in Canada. Let's welcome Maria Victoria Alicia Recinto.
Hi. Thank you so much for having me.
Congratulations, first of all. We're so proud
Thank
of you.
You. And you can call me Ria.
Ria, okay.
Maria Victoria Alicia is a little bit of a mouthful.
Yeah, welcome to Adobo Nation. So Ria, if I might ask you, you know, it's not every day that we see a Filipina in this type of sport. Usually, more Europeans, you know. What got you started in the sport, Ria?
Well, I was actually doing artistic gymnastics originally. When I was in Singapore, the doctor said I should try doing a sport to get rid of my asthma. Oh. So then I started doing artistic gymnastics. But then when I was 8, we moved to the States. And from there, I just started doing rhythmic gymnastics because the coach, who is my coach right now, she asked me to try out for rhythmic. And as soon as I do it, I knew I instantly would love it.
Oh, so like it's in you. Because you know, some Filipinos, like, especially Filipino mothers, like they always enroll their kids in
playing piano, doing karate.
Yeah. So when you actually started doing it, you loved it.
Yeah, but it was also, my mom was also a big help. She also wanted me to do something, and I was also lucky enough to find something that I knew I would love instantly.
So why? What made you love the sport initially? I mean, you, you know, tried it out, and then what about the sport that really clicked inside you, Ria?
The grace of it, just watching the sport and watching all the other gymnasts, the top tier gymnasts, it was just amazing. I was captivated by the ribbons, just the
so
amazing
flexibility. So you love to dance as well, because rhythmic, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
So now that you're part of the Philippine national team, was it ever an issue since you lived here in the States?
No, because I was actually born in the Philippines. So I'm a naturally born citizen, so I was just knew that I wanted to compete for the Philippines ever since I was a little girl.
So how often do you go to the Philippines for gymnastics?
Last year, 2010, I went back to the Philippines twice, once for nationals and then another time for pre-training before Asian Games.
We always hear every time there's Olympic year, you know, these girls go out to camps for months on end, away from their families to do training. And what's training like for you, Ria?
Well, I train here in California. I train in Mountain View in a gym called Twister Sports Center. And I've been there since I was 8 years old. So it's basically been my second home.
Yeah.
Yeah, every day. And then I would have, I only go to school for 4 hours a day. I get out of school 12:25. And then I try to get to the gym anywhere between 1:30 or 2 so I can start practicing. And then my practice will go anywhere until 7:30 or 8.
Okay, so you brought us some. You brought some apparatus here. Can you show us some moves? We're so interested. Like we can't wait for you.
So can't wait to see.
Show us.
So the ribbon is the most common apparatus that's mostly associated with rhythmic gymnastics, and it includes snakes, spirals.
Wow.
Look at how she does it so effortless.
So that's the ribbon, and then there's also the ball.
The ball.
Yeah, here you go. You can play
Thank
with that
you.
If you want.
Wow.
And so the ball is generally rolls like that.
Ria, which one's your favorite out of all this apparatus?
Oh, my favorite would definitely have to be the hoop.
The hoop.
Yeah, the
that
hoop.
That could be a good workout. You should try that. Okay, can you show us how to do it?
So the hoop is basically a bunch of small tosses, and there's also rolls. Behind the back.
Wow. Maka Nation, don't try this at home unless you're a professional.
You might hit some stuff. And then that. And this is called an unlevel balance, unstable balance. And there's also ways you can manipulate.
What about the club?
Oh, the clubs are definitely the scariest apparatus.
Yeah.
Yeah,
why
I got a
that?
Black eye. From
oh, really?
It.
Wow.
They're pretty scary because they're made of hard plastic.
Oh.
And so if it hits you, then it really hurts.
Can knock you out.
It takes a lot of practice. That
yeah.
Okay.
So this is and clubs are my newest apparatus.
I see. So.
Too. So it's
so how long does it take for somebody like you to train, especially if you add a new apparatus in your, you know, how long does it take usually? You know, a few months. You know.
Well, the routines themselves, it's kind of a progressive thing. Like, I learn my routines within about a month and a half, depending
wow.
on how long my coach takes to choreograph them.
Mm-hmm.
And so from there, it just takes me a while to try to get used to the routine and get mm-hmm. used to all the movements and the music. And so...
Really, practice makes perfect.
Yes.
So, Saria, thank you for being on the show. But, you know, what's next for you now that you're competing, you just came from Canada.
Mm-hmm.
What's next in line for Rhea?
Southeast Asian Games, which
yeah.
is my goal for this year.
Okay, so I'm sure you've inspired a lot of African nations out there. So what's your advice to like aspiring gymnasts like you that are watching?
My number one piece of advice mm-hmm. would definitely be work hard
mm-hmm.
and just expect the most out of it, because it's just, if you work hard, then you know that you've done as much as you can and know you've done your best.
And have fun, right?
Yeah.
You
have know? Fun,
so
yes.
Have fun, so.
But before you can really start having fun, you need to start working hard.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, then everything else is easy.
So again, congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you so
We're
much.
So happy
We're so
and proud.
Proud.
Thank you.
Thank you.